mechanism of scar formation, the defection of dermal templates. And the scar is very old, but very important questions that many researchers want to find the ideal treatment, but failed. And even we didn't know the mechanism of scar formation. And these are the recent research focused on the scar research. They did about fibroblast and growth factors, cytokines, and other cellular metrics. But the clinical gave us the other clues. For example, we can see the different suture techniques resulting in different wound healing effect. Indication, the initiation of the scar formation seems to be earlier than the cellular events and the role of the growth factors caused by the wounds. And the other clinical phenomenon includes the first, the lateral scar occurs after superficial burn, while obvious scar occurs after deep burns healed. Second, the degree of scar formation is negatively related with the thickness of the skin grafts. Full thickness of skin graft greatly reduced the scar formation. And little scar occurred after the frostbite healed, for their residue of the intact dermal tissues, especially their structure. This indicates that the degree of the scar formation is related with the level of loss of dermal tissues. Reducing dermal tissues defect by dermal tissue grafting leads to better dermal textures and less scar formation after wound healed, suggesting that the dermal tissue could play an important role in preventing scar formation. And so, what is the initiation of scar formation? And we know that the fibroblast and growth factor cytokines and MMPs, the ECM, just participate and the executor of wound repair. So in order to confirm our hypothesis, we did serious research. First, we want to make the limitation between the dermal defect and the scar formation, and we designed such experiment. First, we compare with the split thickness graft and non-skin graft. Second, we compare the different thickness of skin graft on the healing. The result shows from the upper row, you can see the after the skin graft, the result is better than the non-skin graft. And the more thickness of skin graft, the better result. So we got the first conclusion that the scar formation is positively related with the dermal defect. The dermal transplantation into the wound side reduces the scar. Second, how dermal defect take effect on the scar formation, and we took the full thickness skin graft, and removed some thickness of dermal tissue, and then transplanted to the dermal defect. Then we will supplement the loss of thickness, and add the partial thickness skin graft, and both planted into the dermal defect. So the result shows that the full thickness skin graft and the component tissues get better results. And even you can see here is the full thickness, and the third column is the component tissue. So we can see that the full thickness and the component tissue can regulate the ratio of collagen type 1 and type 3. And the skin tissue compliance get better result in the full thickness and composite tissue. The red bar is the full thickness skin graft, and the purple bar is the composite tissues. So the expression of alpha SMA is decreased in the both groups. And the TGF beta 1 is the same. And integrin alpha 2 and integrin beta 1 get the same result in both groups. So we got the second conclusion that if we supplement to the loss of thickness we can regulate the ratio of the collagen type 1, type 3, and improve the skin skin remodeling and improve the tissue compliance, reduce differentiation of fibroblast into myofibroblast, and regulate the expression of integrin, reduce the expression of TGF beta 1. And in the end, we can greatly reduce the scar formation. So we translate the research into clinical research, and we get 94 patients with deep burns after rectomy, and we gave the patient first gave them the cellular dermal matrix at the skin thickness skin graft, and the control groups just gave them the skin split thickness skin graft, and the result confirmed the animal experiment. So in our third research, and we use both biomaterials. So one is decalcified bone matrix, and the second is a bio sponge. We transplanted on the back of the skin tissues. Then we can see the left photograph is inside the 3D structures, and the right is outside the 3D, and we can see the expression of alpha SMA is decreased in the inside 3D. So from these two photos, we can see that inside the 3D, there is composed of many different pore size. So next we will we will create the different process into the biomaterials, then transplant into the dermal defect, and we divide it into three groups. One group is the pore size is 200 millimeters, the second is 500 millimeters, third is 1,000 millimeters, and we can see that three groups is different in the different time point. The expression of alpha SMA, and the expression of proliferatory cellular nuclear antigen is different in three groups at three different time points. The apoptosis of cells is also different in three groups at a different time point. And next, we will destruct the biomaterials and transplant them in the dermal defect. And so the upper row is the intact biomaterials. The lower row is the non-integrity of 3D. So we can see that the upper in the upper row, there is better result in the at different time point. So we got the three conclusion that 3D dermal tissues can serve as a template that induction the fibroblast function. The tissue integrity and continuity due to trauma leads to a lack of the template effect. And the dermal defect and their level of severity affect the hypertrophic scar formation. The tissue structure can act as template that guard cell function while the tissue integrity and continuity is a prerequisite for repair to take place. Loss of dermal tissue integrity and continuity due to trauma leads to lack of the template effect, which may be one important mechanism that hinders the recovery of cell function and resulting in the scar formation. Taken together, these observations lead us to hypothesize the theory of dermal template effect. Next, what is the dermal template and what is the structure of the dermal template? And we know that the ECM is mostly composed of the collagens. And from this illustration, we can see that and now we know the structure of the collagen molecules and the structure of microfibers and the structure of fibers. But we don't know how the fibers weave the structure of the extracellular matrix, that means dermal tissues. So we want to know what's the structure of the dermal tissues. So we take the normal dermal tissue and the scar normal tissue after treated, and we use this phase contrast microtomography with synchrotron radiation. Use these tools, we got the preliminary result at present. So this is the normal dermal tissues, and this is the scar dermal tissues. So the result shows that there are differences. There is significant difference between the normal dermal tissue and the scar tissues, and the overall structure is basic unit of the normal dermal tissues, which is composed of the collagen fibers. The overall structure is right-handed helix, and the collagen fibers is left-handed helix. The louver-like structures were showed on the collagen fibers. And in scar tissues, there is no over structure. And between the collagen fibers, there is the severe adhesion. And although we can, in the scar formation, we can see the louver-like structures, but the shape of louver-like structure is regular. And so I think in future, we will further to do this kind of research, want to find the ideal skin tissue engineering to prevent scar formation in the end. And this is our research group. And thank you for your attention.